everybody. Good afternoon. It's right now our time for us to begin with our WMYSK online series. And before I officially invite and introduce our guest speaker here today, so again, my name is Wesley and we have Lawrence right here. So for those of you who have just joined in, again, thank you so much for taking your time joining us in part of our initiative to impart more knowledge and the right source of information. So again, before we officially begin, I would like to address and invite all of you here for joining me. And do also help us to like and share this video so it can benefit many more people out there. And of course, as usual, for those of you here who help us to like and share, and make sure you keep it at a public privacy status so that you will be able to stand a chance to win the Tone Touch & Go Tone M Limited Edition Touch & Go card, right? And so that's one. And number two as well, so again, help us to like and share and things like that. So right now, okay, so again, it's me, Westy, and we have Lawrence here today. All right, so we are very honored to have Kelly Chong, Digital Marketing Consultant, CEO of DMC Solutions. All right, so perhaps, Kelly, would you want to just quickly introduce yourself?
Hi, everyone. My name is Kelly. Okay, I'm the CEO of DMC Solutions. Basically, my company actually is doing increase the online presence and also helping all the SME and corporate to increase the inquiry, okay, and especially nowadays, like the COVID-19 lockdown, okay, so we will try to help all these SME owners to get more online presence and also to generate more leads from them, yeah.
Right, I think you mentioned a very important point about online presence, but I think now is the right time, where it comes in very timely right now.
Yes.
And as a result, I'm going to grab you and to share with you your knowledge and your insights. Okay, Lawrence, you want to say hi to our audience first, Lawrence?
Hey, hi, hello. again, every time when you ask me this question, I always forget we are at day one of MCO. And apparently, I just realized today is Sunday. So, Kelly, thank you again for joining us on a Sunday afternoon.
Despite on a Sunday, right? All right, and for those of you here who have just joined in, I would also invite you to say hi to Kelly so that I know you're watching this video right now. Okay, so before we go into the questions we want to ask you, I think the first thing I'm very curious to ask is, so since MCO has been recently extended again, so what's the first thing that came into your mind?
Lockdown. You definitely cannot go out. So I think it will really impact a lot of people in a different way.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if let's say there are those working, of course, they are trying to adapt, okay, the lifestyles, which you need to stay at home and work from home. I mean, it's actually applicable same to the bosses as well. But I think the bosses will have more things to think, okay, because you need to how to actually still make sure the business as usual, okay, as much as possible during this lockdown. So that's why I think a lot of people still will try to figure out, okay, whether they are go for the planning or they are go for the implementations, okay, to make sure their business can be come back to as usual as possible.
Right. I think it's very spot on that, of course, everybody hopes that we can recover during and post-COVID. So here comes my next question to you. Now, during MCO, right, I think there is a lot of businesses, people, employees, salespeople, business owners, suddenly all jump into the space of digital and also in terms of e-commerce. So do you think that this will create like overly congested? Really, do you think it is crowded?
Okay, to my opinion, I don't think so. Because online actually giving a very wide space, okay, as compared to the traditional marketing. Because based on online, you can actually extend out of the boundary already. Maybe you can actually push it out, your brand or your business, okay, to even to oversee. All right. So that's why they actually can develop even better as compared to the traditional business. So that's why, and also in the online platform, right? There's an algorithm, it will be showing your business or brand to a relevant audience. So that's why I think now is the best time for those like SME people to spread out their brand or businesses out to online so that more people will know about it. So that's why I don't think there will be a congested. It's just that different people will attract to a relevant content.
Good.
And also depends on the brand positioning and also their uniqueness. Yeah. Okay. So that's why this is where actually they can attract more people to their products.
I think this is something interesting because when you mentioned about brand positioning, it means strategies needs to take place, right? So yesterday I actually managed to watch you and Charles. You have a live video yesterday. So I think it's a very good video because you were asking questions and Charles were answering on how you sell your website. And I think these are part of strategy, right? Of how to do a good website. So my question to you, Kelly, is in whatever that we venture in regardless of what industry, I think the right strategy is very important. So I think this is also why we are having you today on to share with us what are the five strategies that you want to share with our audience on overcoming this crisis.
Okay. Thanks. Thanks, Dato. Okay. So for the question, okay, for the five strategies, right? Okay, first of all, I mean, if for those like business owner, I actually categorize them first. If let's say those are already in the business for a few years already or more than 5 years, definitely they will have a lot of like database, customer database. If let's say for those of people have a database, the most important thing is maybe they can actually try to build the rapport back to the current existing customers. Okay, because it's where the cost and also the efforts actually will be lesser if you still try to go back to the existing customer, because it's more easier because they already know about your products. And then for those who don't have any customer database, okay, do not have any database at all, right? Then they need to try to check out where is their customer now, what is their customer behavior, what is their habits now. Okay, then from there, then you can determine what kind of platform they need to go, like to do the online presence or online digitalizations. Okay, example, give you an example. Like those like selling like products. Okay, live commerce. Nowadays, live commerce is a very popular because everyone actually spending more than 4 hours online every day. So that's why they can actually go all the way for live commerce. And this one actually is the most budget. Right, because you go to the Facebook Live, you can straight away just live only, just use a button. You just need to script out.
Is it Facebook Live? Is it those that actually go on live and say, "Oh, you want to buy this vegetable now?" Is that live commerce?
Yes, because this is the faster way to let them know about your products. With a very lower cost. Yeah. So that's why you also come back to see actually what is the business nature as well. I mean, for those like as I just mentioned, right, like B2C, business to consumer. Those type of products, okay, means that they are not so high ticket item. High ticket item means that they are lower price, like less than 100 ringgit.
Okay.
Okay. So that kind of products, then you straight away go to live commerce, like doing the live, like sharing to everyone. Like you're selling snack, you're selling veggie, you're selling meat, you're selling seafood. So all these things, people will become like an essential, then people will pick up very fast. And the coverage will be very fast as well. Using live. Okay, then after that, the next one will be more high ticket item already. Higher ticket item also same things like products. Higher ticket will be like, example, like, I'm still talking about a bit of essential things. I'm not talking about the luxurious, okay? Talking about essential things, but the high tickets. Example, maybe some of them is like a property. Okay, then this one, maybe you need to come in like different objective already. You need to come with a more on providing value. Okay, doing more on branding awareness. Okay, before, after lockdown already, people go out. The first thing, when they remember who is the brand, okay, they still remember the brand of that property. Then they will actually will go into it. So that's why different industry, you will have different strategies.
Right.
Okay, this is more to have a product basis. Okay, the next one will be the B2B business. B2B means a business to business. So when it comes to B2B business, then there were different strategies already. When you come to the business, live commerce is not so relevant to them. Then what will be the next? Then maybe the next thing is will be more on Google. Because people habits, the consumer habits change already. People now will rely on the online more than last time. Last time maybe some of the people they still not really believe it. Okay, they're not really believe it. Maybe there's the usage maybe about 50 to 60%, but now it's almost like totally up to about 95% already. So that's why people behave, people habits different. When they search for something, information is also different. So that's why for B2B business, maybe they need to take more attentions and research more also in Google, such as like Google Ads, okay? Or maybe the Google My Business, which is using the local business. It's very benefit to the local business or SEO. Or or maybe up to YouTube as well. You can create more content. It's just that you need to find where is the audience, where is the customer is. Then from there, you can do more content, relevant content to attract them. That's it.
Right. Yeah. Okay. I want to ask you a very, very interesting question. So you talk about providing value and content, right? Okay, of course, content is something that's beneficial in value. I think one of the common questions that a lot of people may ask is that it's how can I create continuous content, continuous value to my target audience? So what's your take on this? How to continuous create content?
Okay. Same things. You also come back to the business nature. Because some of the people, if let's say I'll just give more examples, I mean it will be more related to people can more visualize it. Okay, yes, example, if let's say you're using those beauty products, products or those consumer products, you're selling the cooker utensils, everything, right? Okay, then you can do more demo or the cooking utensil, or maybe for beauty. Straight away, you can do every time your daily, you doing how to do the facials things, how to actually maintain your skin. So whenever you apply the beauty products, then you straight away, you record it. You use a video marketing to record it. Then after that, you post it out. So all these things will be content. So what is the format about the content is not so important. It's the matter of how you actually want to convey the important message and also your unique selling point of your product or services to your audience, to the relevant audience. So that's why so this is the I would like to share.
All right. So a follow-up question which I'm also quite curious. Is the content always selling or is the content just educating people?
Educating people. You can mix, but 80% is more on educating people. Providing value to the people, because when you consistently providing value, people will start to people will start to trust you. They're building up some kind of trust. Then people will start to think you are the an authority. You know, you're like a school. Every time when we go to school, right? Every time teachers say what, then we say, whatever teachers say, then we will listen to it. So that's why we need to develop us or publish us as an authority in our own industry. So the more value that you are giving, then people will start to trust you. Then from there, sometimes on and off, you sell anything, right? People will buy it. Right. Yeah, so this is how it works.
All right. I think very interesting perspective. And for those of you watching, Kelly, Jana saying hi to you. Somebody joining us. Hi. And for those of you here also watching, keep continuing saying hi to us so they know you're watching this right now. And again, our topic here today, we're going to talk about digitalization of businesses. And we've got Kelly here today joining us. All right. So I think, Kelly, you talk about very interesting points, talk about digitalization. But I think still got some group of people where they resist or they are not sure whether they want to digitize or not. So what do you think stop people from doing this transformation, and what is your advice to them?
Some of the people, there's two group of people why they actually they don't want to digitalize their business. Group of people is maybe their current marketing strategies works very well before lockdown. They are in a comfort zones already. So that's why to them, they feel that, you want me to actually try to venture something that's very new, okay? Then they kind of not believe in that, okay? Yeah. So this is the first group of people. Then there's another group of people, why actually they don't want to jump into the digitalization is they maybe have some failed cases before. They try it, but it doesn't bring in the preferable results. So that's why they think that, no, this strategy definitely is not works. So, okay, I separate into two groups. Okay, so for the first group wise, I think now these current situations, right, there's no other excuses for them to not to try for the digitalizations anymore. Because you can see everyone is locked down. So our mobility is very hard. We can't even go out. Even though after lockdown finish, right, I believe that a lot of people, they won't, they still won't have that kind of habits like, oh yeah, let's go party. Okay, because our habits is start to change already. Okay, more people actually try to do the online activities at home. Yeah, so that's why I think for those group of people, I think this is a time they really need to venture. Okay, maybe they can start to get some basic knowledge in either in YouTube, or maybe you can see there's a lot of Facebook Live, okay? A lot of people sharing about how to do Facebook, how to digitalize. I think just after you watch about 10 or 20, you already have the basic ideas already how actually this digitalization works.
Yeah.
So this group of people, yeah, maybe they need to try at this first, start to do some planning. But now I think we have locked down about 3 weeks already. I think it's planned enough already. So if let's say those people who haven't planned yet, so yeah, you really have to do it fastest already. Then for those already planned, then it's a time to start to implement it. Then for those another group which is maybe they have failed case before. So first of all, maybe you need to for them, maybe they can list out what is the mistakes previously they actually go through before.
Yeah.
What is the mistakes? And then what is the resources they have now? What is the resources they have now? And basically, maybe it's like a team. How many teams member they have? Okay, then leverage on the manpower, and also what kind of fund they have. I mean, in terms of the cash flow, all right. Yeah. So after you analyze from all these things, right? Then you can actually get either you want to do it by yourself, but of course you need longer time.
Yes.
You need to test and then do longer time. If let's say you want to do it by yourself, but if not, then you have to find and outsource to other people. So when the outsource process, then you really have to go and see what is the review, ask them to show you what is the previous project before. Then you have to go into more in-depth conversations with them, communications. But before you go and talk to all those agency, the best thing is still have to equip themselves the very basic knowledge. So this is two groups.
I think it's very good. It's very important. And for those that who have failed cases, I really recommend that you all speak to DMC, because I personally been working with them over the year. I feel that they really will walk you through whatever that you need to ask and you need to question. But Kelly, I have a follow-up question on this. I think there's a lot of talks about digitalization. It's such a simple word, but yet it's also not something easy to do. You see, I think out of 10 people that we speak with, I think 10 people will say, yes, we need to digitalize, we need to go. But people feel that to embark on the digitalization, they need a lot of funds, they need a lot of talent. So is this entirely true? And what is your take on this?
Okay. So your Dato, you have actually you have two questions into it. One is whether they need to use a very big fund, money, and then the other one will be talent. Okay, so I'll touch on the money side first. Okay.
Yeah.
Actually, basically, if let's say you compare the online digitalizations, right, compare with the traditional marketing, I would say for those already jump into two things, because when you have a two experience, then you only can compare.
Correct.
Okay, so that's why, I mean, if let's say you really compare for both, right, digitalizations is always cheaper than the traditional marketing. Actually, there has two things. Okay, one thing is, when you do the traditional marketing, right, it's very hard for you to track.
Yep.
It's very hard for you to track. So whatever you go for the traditional marketing, and then you need more on like a face-to-face, human touch, right? This is a traditional marketing. But nowadays, like this lockdown, even though after lockdown, things change already. So these chances, like face-to-face, will be reduced tremendously. So in terms of you're talking about cost of opportunity also, the cost of opportunity, actually, when you, let's say you're still running for the traditional marketing, you will actually reduce you will be actually facing loss, basically. You're facing loss because you lost a lot of cost of opportunity. But for digitalization, because you can actually reach out to a lot of people. Okay, you can reach out to a lot of people. And also one thing, if let's say previously you have a database, right? You can immediately, okay, to do remarketing already online. Because you have all their database. And same things, I mean, if, this one is more technical. If let's say for those already know how to do the Facebook advertisement, you can straight away create lookalike. Then you can further target to other customers. So that's what I'm talking about. All these money things are because of the cost of opportunity, because of the way to tracking and to do the retargeting. Basically, you save more and you can earn more than the traditional way. Okay, so this is a more on a money side, the budget side. So now I'm talking about the talent. Okay, even though talent wise, you talk about the like traditional marketing, you also still need a marketing exec. You need a marketing manager. You also need to have the graphic design. You need copyrights as well. So all this is in your team already. All right. Mm-hmm. But now digital marketing is extensive from marketing as well. So that's why maybe what you need to add up is another digital marketers. So to me, I mean, for the in terms of the talent wise, it just depends on how you actually want to leverage on it only. So once you leverage in a good way, basically the talent is still the same. And then in terms of budget, basically you can further save up your cost.
So I think this is very good breakdown of both money and also talent. But I think this is also the two very crucial part. I think a lot of people say we are lack of talent in terms of data analytics, in terms of digital marketeers. This is what I feel. But maybe you want to tell us what is actually happening on the ground. Do we really have lack of talent in terms of digital marketeers and even people in the data analytics, digital marketing? And in terms of funds, has maybe we are not very dependent on the government, but I'm just saying that has the government done enough? Or is there any private GLCs or government agencies that are working on helping the businesses to provide funds for digitalization?
Okay. Inside there's a lot of questions. Okay, yeah. I touched about the talent first.
Correct.
Just you mentioned the talent is regarding to like are we having talent? Do we have enough of talent? But I think compared to last few years, I think now we are improving. We are improving. Of course, if you let's say we are compared to like Western country, right? We are still not to like having advanced as them, okay, the level of advancement. But I think now we are improving. And you can see also there's in the market, there's a lot of training center about digital marketing. So I can see that a lot of people now, they start to leverage and also there's a lot of people acquire that kind of knowledge already. But of course, if you mention until like very expertise, okay, it really depends on different people knowledge level. Okay, because some of the people, maybe they are more expert in Facebook. Some of them, maybe they are more expert in Google. Okay, that's why you really have to use more effort and maybe go through the networking to check it out whether where is their strength of the agency or maybe for the freelancer as well. So this is more on the talent. This is more on the talents. Okay, so and then the other one is the just like I mentioned, is about the budgets, right?
Budget, yes,
yeah, the budget. Okay, so for the budget wise, I think in the Malaysia currently, right, government from MDEC, they do have some kind of program, okay, is helping the SME currently, all right? Okay. And a very, I'm not sure this one I can say or not, because it's a very pressure that DMC Group, we also is part of the program as well. So that's why, for those people who really want to know more, then maybe they can actually follow the DMC. So because we actually announced this, it's actually the program is only for those like SME to help them for the digitalizations.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and follow up to that, right? So like you say, I mean, it actually is just a matter of how to do it, right? Okay, so you mentioned a good point where you talk about talent and all these things. You talk about fear, you know, people's negative experience, because I think back then, okay, digital marketing means, okay, let's go Facebook ads, and everybody go and dump money into Facebook ads, right? And, okay, so in your opinion, what industry will be very tough to adapt to digitalization in your experience?
Okay, to me, there's none of any industry is very hard to adapt the right. digitization. It's just a matter like previously, at the beginning, I already mentioned that it really comes back to your business nature. If let's say you're running for the B2B, it's just that you need to find the right platform, okay, to expose your business. But if let's say you are B2C, okay, then maybe you should go to like more on social media. So to me, there's none of one industry who really have a toughness to adapt into these digitalizations. Yeah, right. You just need to find where is your customer is, and then you just go and reach out to them only. That's it.
Right. Okay. So another follow-up question. So you say all businesses should, and in fact, all businesses are also suitable for digitalization. Okay, do you have any tips that as of now during this current lockdown, what are some practical steps, strategies that you can recommend business owners out there to immediately implement now for them to digitize their business? Any recommendation for them?
Sorry, again, because just now I can't...
Oh, okay. So like now during... Okay, especially in Malaysia now, we're having lockdown, right? So basically, we are supposed to stay at home. I mean, we are staying at home, right? And so what do you recommend some practical, actionable strategies so that business owners at home now can do to digitize their business?
Okay, to my opinion, you can leverage on the team.
Okay.
Leverage on the team. Okay, have a meeting with the team first. Yeah. Leverage on the team, and then maybe you can write down like ask the team how to co-promote the business.
Okay.
And the product as well. So you can see, if let's say you have a team, maybe takes about 5 people or 10 people.
Yeah.
Let's say example, you have 10 people in your team. So if every team member also share consistently, share about the company products or the services,
yep.
Then after you share already, they might have another 10 share. So the momentum will be there. Then the consistency of the exposure will be there as well.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, so that's why you just have to leverage on the team. And this is the, I'm talking in from the perspective is how to actually saving more costs.
Okay.
Yeah, but this is a faster way. This is the fastest way. Okay. So after from there already, then the second thing you'd have to think of, it will be the content. What kind of content that the current audience, okay, they might be interested.
Yep.
Then from there, then you craft it out. Yep. Then you can actually recycle it as well. Like recycle the content, like maybe in the poster or maybe in the video, okay, or maybe in the writing the articles to post up into your website. Okay, so that you can push up the rank. So there's many ways that you actually can figure it out. It's supposed to be a very, very busy week during the lockdown.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's another question for you. Because we talk about creating content, how do we know that is the right content? I mean, like, of course, we want to add value and educate people, but how do I know it's the right content that people want to see, that it will help? Or because sometimes I think a lot of business owners think that, hey, my content is right, but maybe the target audience don't think it's the right content. How do we find a balance, the right content between the business owners and the target audience?
Okay. How to confirm the right content? Okay, that's one thing is, look at your competitor, what they do.
Okay.
What they do. So, right. Because when they do some things, right, you can see there's engagement. Whether it's a high engagement or not, is it a lot of people participate in their content? So if let's say a lot of people actually participate in the contents, right? Then from there, you will know that this kind of content will really attract the people. Right. And then those people who really look into your competitor content is your customer as well. So that's why from there, you will know what kind of content you should draft. So, okay, then after that, you draft already, you post up your contents already. Then after that, because you have a lot of analysis behind the back end, the dashboard there. So from there, you can start to analyze, okay, about the engagement rate, about the click, about the comment, about the sharing. Okay, so from there, then you will know that how many people will really like to which particular content. Then from there, you just do more for the content. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I think I it's very interesting because it's not easy to actually create good content or even, let's say, a relevant content for your relevant audience. I think this is something very challenging for my printers as well. But I have actually a very curious question, Kelly. Actually, I do not know if you have the numbers or if you have the figures. How many percent of businesses actually already started to adopt this digitalization? Do you have the figures? Do you roughly know how many companies are out there are still not embarking on this yet at the moment?
Okay, from the previous, lockdown period, okay, what we have, the numbers are, is actually less than 30%.
Whoa. Okay.
Less than 30% are people doing the transformations, okay? Okay. Especially for those like heavy industry. Okay, I can say that a lot of heavy industry, a lot of those like businesses survive more than 30 to 40 years.
Okay.
They are not yet having any digitalizations yet. Okay, and then this one is exactly like at the beginning I also mentioned before already. It's just that some of the people they feel very skeptical, and they are because they are too comfortable to whatever they are earning now with the current marketing plans. So right. That's why then they will be very skeptical. How you actually can using just a Facebook, how you are going to earn sales from that? So a lot of people were actually skeptical from that. But I think that from this lockdown, right? Some of the people, they start to have awareness already. They will know that if, let's say, they haven't do any digital transformations, they will really, really badly affect their business. So I think from now on, the percentage will definitely go up. But I don't have the percentage, for after the lockdown, okay? I don't have it. But I think it definitely will increase more than 50% nowadays. But some of them, they may be stuck, okay? They're stuck into that because they do not have enough time because they are not response fast. That's why they're stuck into that. So that's why it really depends on how the business owner, how they respond now, start from this lockdown period onwards. So if let's say they can respond fast, to me, I will still think positive. I think they still have times to quickly to do the digitalizations. Yeah.
I think this is very important. Responding to crisis is so important that actually, to be very frank, Kelly, this is also my first time doing Facebook Live. Along this lockdown period, I've never wanted to be shown on videos. So I actually gave my first time to Wesley as well. So I'm actually very honored to do this with you all, good friends like you all. But I think there's one more question on follow-up on that, on the speed of digitalization adapting. I think one issue among businesses is legacy. I think the legacy between the older generation, like you say, businesses that may be 10 years or 20 years down the road, you know, the legacy from the founder and then maybe now to the young people who take over, they of course have a different mindset. I want to digitalize, but the founders are all, no, I'm not so interested. Yes. Have you actually met this kind of people, and what advice would you like to give to these companies?
Okay, I did met a lot of this kind of business as well. That's not just what I mentioned already. Those business is like more than 30 years or 40 years, right? Because it's a legacy place. And then I saw a lot of third generations, or fourth generation, when they take over the business, right, they have this kind of problems. They try very, very hard to convince their family members or the board of meetings, those like already maybe age more than 60 years old. So that's why they will try to convince them how actually all this strategy will work. But I think one thing is it's just that those elder generations, right, they don't have the confidence.
Right.
They don't have the confidence. There. But I think it must be have a starting point. So maybe you can start with a small project, prove to them that this small project actually it works well, or maybe it really brings the benefits or maybe profit. Okay, shows the number to the elder generations. Then maybe from there, they will start to like, okay, all right, I see there's some results already. Then maybe I should actually put more budget into the digitalizations. Yeah, so but basically they just need something numbers to convince them, to show them that okay, this method actually it works.
Right.
Yeah. But sometimes maybe you even though okay, to us, right, we are as agency, sometimes we didn't tell them that okay, maybe you just 100% to switch all your business to the digitalizations. Maybe you can come up with some a small pipeline, a new pipeline. Okay, new pipeline cater for a new crowd. So from there, basically you can help the clients, right, or the SME owners, okay, to build another new a new pipeline or new profit for them.
Yeah.
So that's why from there, then they will start to have they will see that this is a calculated risk already, and then it's maybe it's a good way to go. Then now actually we have a target, another new customer, new market segmentations. So that's why then from there they will start to build up the confidence level.
Right. Very good. I think a good point where you should talk about small projects, getting started, prove some results, and then we can show to people, right? And for those of you here, in case you've got any questions, feel free to drop your questions, and we will just take in a few more questions. Okay, so in my perspective, so you talk about starting small projects, which I think companies can start doing right now, especially during MCO. Based on your experience, right, what are some examples of small projects that they can start now? Do you have any examples or any just case studies? I mean, of course, you can't reveal your client's name, but any examples, any case studies that you have?
Okay, if those people who are already in the business, right, whether they are now still in a traditional business, you just need to improvise only. Maybe I'll give you an example. Yes. Like one example, a very good example would be like T-Life.
Okay.
I can say that, right? I can say it's a brand name, right?
I don't know, is it your client's okay or not?
No.
Okay.
Example like T-Life. Basically, previously they actually have a physical store, right?
Correct.
They have a physical store, but after that already they actually improvise it. They make it into like a you can actually do it at home DIY. So that's why they improvise it. They improvise it because then from there they actually can reduce their stock. They can reduce their stock, and furthermore they actually come up generate another new line.
Yes.
So this is the first thing. Then I also saw the other one is selling vegetable. They're selling vegetable. They only cater for to a restaurant, hotel. Okay, they are the suppliers to those like B2B businesses. But after lockdown already, right, within 2 days, they immediately switch it to online.
Yeah.
Okay, they immediately switch it to online, and then they do the home delivery to cater for household consumptions. Yeah, so I also saw there's another is a burger regarding to the burger or steak. I also forgot already. So same things. They also immediately within 2 days. Okay, they just put it like okay. Now you actually can have a steak at home. So they give them like a very proper equipment, everything. So this is the matter of how fast you can actually improvise the plan. So instead of you come up with a totally new project selling a totally new products or services which is you don't. Familiar with that, or maybe you have to go and find out to do more research about the marketing segmentations, everything. Why not you improvise from your current products? Okay, so if let's say you come with the current products or your projects, right? Then you will know, because you already know who is your target customer, and then how actually many they will convert. Okay, how they actually will start to purchase about your product and your services. Then from there, you just have to tweak a little bit. Okay, to make it into an online delivery service or product, then basically it will be, and you can create another new profit already. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's a very good example case study, especially T-Life. Although I only take it sometimes, but once the MCO was implemented, immediately I already see my friends actually started to have the home pack. I think, like you said, one, improvise, second is the speed, the agility is very important. And a follow up question on that. I really am very attracted to the name of your company, DMC Solutions. Solutions is more important because friends who know me very well, including Charles, including Zevin, including Wesley, they know that I practically don't really like consultants. So
okay.
Can you tell us, Kali, what does DMC Solution do? And do you actually handhold? I think handholding is very important because digitalization is such a wide. It could be about HR, it could be about marketing, it could be about so many things, automation of so many things. So Can you tell us what the DMC solution do? And actually, in terms of handholding the companies, how do you handhold them?
Okay. Basically, DMC solution, because the full name actually is a digital marketing consultancy solutions. Okay. Mm. We only provide services to those people who, let's say, I don't want to have a team. I don't want to hands on. I just want to have a peace of mind. You help me to settle everything. So basically, we will provide a services or the solutions to the SME only in digital marketing automations.
Okay.
So for those people, if let's say you want to find how to actually push your brand name, okay, into the markets, okay, to let more people to know about it, okay, then the good things that you can actually always outsource to the agency like us. Yeah, so that's why to us, our strength is more on like still Google and social media, okay? But before we actually recommend on all these platforms, because all this is just a marketing tools, but to us, we will come with the point is how to actually make sure how to help the company and customize the strategies for them. Because like I mentioned previously, different people, actually, different company actually have a different problems, right? And also, they also have a different KPI to meet and having a different objective as well. So that's why we will actually understand what is the problem they are facing first. Then only we will start to give them the solutions or suggest the solution to them. And then see how we actually can collaborate and make the program success.
Yeah, I think it's also very important about this part. So I personally have been working with DMC. I think my practice... I think friends who know MyPrentice, we have been very offline. We are in our fifth year and we have done a lot of offline campaigns. But like I said, this is the first year that we are online as well. So my follow-up question on this, if those people who really want to get a consultation and they want to get some ideas about how they can actually digitalize their business, so are they able to actually come and get consultation from you first before they decide on what are the things they need to do? Are you able to analyze? That's my question. Are you able to analyze what is needed in the so-called digital marketing space on digitalizing the business? Are you able to analyze?
Yes. Okay, before actually we meet up our clients, right, we definitely will run a campaign audit. If let's say they're already running any digital marketing campaign, we'll run a campaign audit for them, or we will run a marketing the market research audit first. Okay, we will check it out. What is their current positions online, and also what will be them compare with their competitors. So from there, then we will know what will be the real positioning. Then only we will propose the relevant strategies to them.
So thus, I think it is not like a one size fits all. But again, they have to come and talk to you. You run a campaign audit, check. Market research to better understand them, right? So I think it has a lot of personalization, and hence for any one of you here, if you would like to just address, or you may just want to speak to Kelly, just feel free to reach out to her. And unfortunately, again, we have want to ask you questions, but again, we're almost reaching the end of the program. Okay, just one last question for you, right? When do you know it's the right time for a company to do digital transformation? When is the right time?
I think now.
At least you say now. We asked before Touch and Go, they say it was yesterday.
I think because yesterday something passed, you cannot control already. So what you can do is the now, the now moment. Yeah, this is the exact start from now, okay? Whether you already have a plan or whether you don't have a plan and start to plan. Okay, the key words here actually is actions. Okay. What you need to do is you just have to start to work it out. Even though maybe some of the people they have a skeptical, they are not really confident with whether the directions they are moving is correct or not. But I think after actions ready, then only you will know, because after actions you will have a lot of data. Then from there you just analyze. Then you start to improve from there a bit by a bit. Just one step, a small step, one time. Eventually you will find the right solutions. But the keywords here definitely is I have to actions. If let's say no actions, then it was a bit hard to plan further steps.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So thank you so much, Anna. And I think one thing that really sparked very well, just like you said, was 3 weeks already in MCO. Plan also plan finished already. So it's time to execute. And one of the things that you shared just now was, again, understanding talent and technology and all. But I think one thing that strikes me today is start small projects, like how we can learn from other people like T-Life and all. So at least we can begin, initiate some projects to make sure that once it's ready, then we can scale bigger. All right. So thank you so much for your time. And I want to take this opportunity to say thanks for those of you watching. And I want to do a very quick shout out again. Help us to also like and share this post so that we can benefit many, many, many more people out there as well. Now, one more quick shout out again is this. So basically what we have right now is, in My Apprentice, we are running this campaign called My Apprentice Care for the support of the frontliners and the deserving family members. So how can you be part of this is that I'm going to drop this link in the comment. All right, so we invite for those of you here who want to participate in this, you can actually join us in our Telegram channel. So it's our Telegram channel, https://myapprentice. Again, we want to welcome all of you here to join us to support our frontliners and their deserving family members. So one more time, thank you so much, Kelly, for joining again. Okay, Kelly, any last advice, encouragement to our friends before we say goodbye?
Okay, to what I say is just look back to what the resources that you have.
Okay.
Okay. And then implement it, leverage on your resources, and take action.
Yeah. Take action. Fantastic. All right. Thank you for your time. And Lawrence, you want to say anything before we end?
Yes. Again, I want to thank you so much, Kelly, and also to thank your team that has been supporting My Apprentice initiatives for the longest time. But I really want to recap on this. It is not just about taking action. I think to resonate today's title is taking action with the right strategies. So I think it's very important to speak to the right people, and like people like us from My Apprentice. Again, it's not difficult to have a Facebook account. It is less than 2 minutes away to create a Facebook account or a Google account. But what is the right and the best strategy to actually help your brand, to actually grow your brand? So I think it's important to talk to the right people. So Kelly, thank you so much. I really enjoyed talking to you. Thank you for your Sunday afternoon. And I think DMC is doing a fantastic job. I usually don't promote, but to those who actually, watching this, please go to DMC's Facebook. And I think they have a lot of all these free webinars that they are doing almost on a everyday basis. I just actually personally watched one yesterday. So now I'm excited to create more websites so that I can sell in the coming days. Okay. Thank you so much, Kelly. I really appreciate
thank
your
you. Thank, thank you, Wesley. Thank you.
Right. And, just before we end, we have a tradition, Kelly. We're going to take a group picture together.
All right.
Virtually, right? Okay. So just look at the camera and show us a love sign.
Okay. Hey,
yes. Okay, wait. Hold on. Maybe I hide the benefits. Okay. Okay. So everybody ready? 1, 2, 3. All right, thank you very much. Thank you so much for your time, Kelly and Lawrence as well. And for those of you watching, one more time, thank you for you. And have a pleasant Sunday afternoon. And have a nice day. Stay safe, stay at home. And till then, everybody, thank you. Signing off from My Apprentice.
Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.